Hey everyone, today I'm working on a 97 Nissan pickup with a KA24E engine. It came in making a lot of upper end noise, so I decided to take off the valve cover, see what was going on. Now, how do you take off the valve cover? There's two bolts up front, there's two in the back, and then there's two on each side, along with the brackets for the spark plug wires and the wiring over here. Now, there is a little push clip back here that I had to get off and push the bracket back in order to get to that bolt right there. And then don't forget about the pipe over there. Now keep in mind your engine might be a little bit different, might be in a car or something, so you might have more or less steps to do. This one's inside of a truck. But once I took the valve cover off, you can see the rocker arm rails, all the rocker arms. I found three of them that were completely loose. There is no adjustment to do on them. They're either good or they're bad. So with them being three completely loose, I was thinking that, you know, this thing's got 180,000 miles on it, might as well just replace them all. So I ordered all the rocker arms. Now, if you don't already know, on the rocker arms there is a front and a back. So on the intake side, you've got the front and the back, and then the front and the back, and therefore, and then on the exhaust side, the same thing, you got a front and a back. So there's four different part numbers that you need if you're going to replace all the rocker arms. Now, how do you take the rocker arm rail off? You take these 10 millimeter bolts out right here. Now, you don't want to take them completely out, but you do want to loosen them up, because if your engine is totally clean and you take them completely out, whenever you take off the rail, if you tilt it to the side, those can just come sliding off because the little brackets hanging on to them come off with the bolts. Now, if it's really dirty like this engine, I actually had to use a rubber mallet like this to tap off the rocker arm. Even after I cleaned it, I couldn't get them off, so I had to tap them all off. So now the new ones went on really easily. I did clean the rails up while everything was apart. You do want to make sure you keep everything in order, because you got to put it all back on correctly. Also, there's not really any lifters in there. There's no adjustments to be made. This is one of the old rocker arms. I'll show you right here. This is where the plunger is. This is called a integrated lifter, but it basically works by feeding oil pressure through the rails on both sides, and it goes through the little hole right there in the rocker arm and then goes out to the plunger and pushes it out. So once you get everything replaced, you know, you might want to soak the rocker arms in oil before you actually put them on there, but once you ever get everything back on in the order it was, go ahead and set the rail back up here and make sure all your surfaces are clean. Now, if you have it off at any time at all, you might want to put a rag across the top so that you don't get any debris on here. But, you know, if you were to set the valve cover back on until you get the parts in, you can do that also. But anyway, once you get the rocker arms back up here, you want to torque everything down. Now, you don't want to crank everything down at the same time. You want to just slowly work your way on, starting from the center bolts and then working your way out until you get even pressure all the way across. Now, after you do it by hand and then you tighten it down a little bit more with a ratchet, you know, make sure you do everything evenly and in a, you know, pattern, you end up going up to 27 to 30 foot pounds of torque. And that's what you'll stop at. But you don't want to crank it down on one side all the way to that right up front. You want to take your time and just go back and forth in that pattern until you get them all tight. And then after that, you're just putting everything back together the way it came off, and that should fix your rattling noise. Sometimes it is the timing chain, but in this case, it was the rocker arms that was making the noise. But anyway, I hope that my video helped you out today. Thanks for watching. If you haven't already, please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.